BBC Audio presents The Secret World, a comedy impression series examining the bizarre private lives of public people. The Secret World, Series 1, originally broadcast in 2008.
White City 503.
Today programme.
Hi, is that Jenny?
Ah, hi, John. Where are you?
Look, I'm going to be a little late today. I stopped off to get some apples and I just noticed
that... Right.
There was an apostrophe on the word apples.
Oh, not again, John.
So, I just had a word with the chap. Well, rather more than a word, actually.
Which hospital are you in?
St. Mary's. It's just a little couple of stitches. It won't take long.
Good, because William Hague is doing the 8:10.
Just ask them to keep the webcams off, because I think it might just look a bit... silly with this. Is it worth it? Put the bandage on my eyes.
10 Downing Street, 524.
Gordon! Alistair Darling's here for your breakfast meeting!
It's okay, it's not locked.
Morning, Gordon. I could wait outside if you...
No. Put the seat down. The work ethic, Alistair, bath time or no. That said, though, I wouldn't wish to be perceived as a person with no sense of fun.
No, absolutely, Gordon. You're a funny guy. People say that all the time.
A funny guy? They say that?
No.
I would need some jokes for PMQs today. Do you have some jokes I can use for PMQs?
Let's see. I recall Margaret Thatcher made a very funny joke. What about, you turn if you want to, but the lady is not going to?
Uh-huh. Is that funny?
I'm assured that it is.
I see. Okay, just pass the sponge, would you? It's just across there.
My eyes are shut.
Okay, just up a bit.
Yep.
Up a little.
Uh-huh.
There you go.
Ah,
you. As well as PMQs, I would also like to be funny at the reception later.
Ah, well, yes. Mr. Churchill was talking to a woman who said, "If I were your wife, I'd poison your coffee," to which he replied, "But in the morning I will be sober. And since I'm your husband, I might be unhappy because you are ugly, and so I would drink the poison." It ends there.
Okay, is that funny?
I'm assured that it is.
I see. Well, we should practice then. You pretend to be a normal person.
Okay.
Good evening. How are you enjoying this drinks reception that we are both attending?
Yes, it's lovely. Can I get you a drink?
Yes, please, but just a normal drink and not poison.
Oh, okay.
Unless you and I were in an unhappy marriage, in which case I might poison myself.
When talking to a stranger, try not to talk about suicide. Busy day?
This morning I had meetings with ministerial colleagues and others. In addition to my duties in the house, I had such further meetings later in the day. Is that funny?
It could certainly be funny.
Well, I'll try it. I'll try it on Alan Carr.
The Friday night project?
He cuts my hair.
Ah, yes.
Notting Hill, 8:12.
William Hague is with us in the studio now. Shadow Foreign Secretary. Well, actually, John, I was never...
Pass the marmalade, would you, Peaches?
Dad!
Yeah?
Someone said to me at the nightclub, right, that you're in Live Aid.
That's right, Peach.
I said to them, no, my dad was in the Boomtown Haps.
Boomtown Rats. I also did Live Aid.
All right, well, who are Live Aid?
You don't know about Live Aid?
Well, I looked it up on iTunes, but it's like loads of different dad bands. And you know that song, Do They Know It's Christmas? Well, it's like really retarded. Like, everyone knows when Christmas is. It's a week before the sale, so...
Live Aid was a monumental event where dozens of bands played all over the world to raise money for the famine.
Oh, famine. All right. Was that like a label?
Peaches, have you ever heard of Ethiopia?
Well, like the designer... You mean like famine by Ethiopia?
Ethiopia is a country in Africa. There were a lot of people starving.
Oh, right. Like my, my friend Agnes Dean, she's like on a diet and she's already like size nothing.
They weren't on a diet. They didn't have enough to eat. The rock industry got together to help out.
Oh, right, wow. So you got together like to promote the starving celebrities of Africa?
There weren't any celebrities. They were just ordinary people, just like you and me.
Oh, I'm not ordinary. Do you not know who I am? Like, my father is Bob Geldof, so...
There is a great deal that you do not know, Peaches.
The Home Office, 10:03.
Hello, this is the office of Hilary Benn. Please leave a message after the little bleep.
Hello, Hilary, it's Jackie Smith here. A bit short notice, but I was just wondering if you'd like to pop over tonight. I'm having a bit of a girls' night in, you know, mutual support for us women. Self-heating face masks, and Ruth's got a lovely selection of her homemade necklaces that she's bringing round, and Yvette and Harriet are coming too. So around seven, Hilary, and bring a bottle.
Hampshire, 12:09.
Hello, Andrew Lloyd Webber speaking.
Andrew, baby, it's Amy.
Oh, hello, Amy.
All right.
I was just listening to Back to Black. How funny.
All right. Andrew, I had a little thing to ask you.
Oh, well, I don't have anything like that, I'm afraid.
No. Right, this is going to sound like a bit out there, a bit, you know, but I want to be in one of your shows.
Oh.
You know, because I want to change, yeah, like, break with the past stuff I've been doing, yeah?
Yeah, absolutely. Well, cool. Well, Amy, I'd certainly be willing to...
Cool.
Amy, which particular show did you have in mind?
The hills are alive with the sound of music.
Oh, surely not Maria.
Yeah, that's the bitch. You don't think my voice is too husky, is it?
No.
Is it my hair? I mean, I could get an extra tall nun's hat.
No, one of them...
Am I too swarthy looking?
No. All it's right. Really nothing like that. It's just when one thinks of Maria, one thinks of innocence, of purity, chastity,
cool,
young woman full of life and love,
cool.
Her whole future before her. Now, when one thinks of you, one thinks of... Hello, you're breaking up. I'm going under a bridge.
What? I phoned your landline. What? Oi! Oi! Oh, fucking
nigger. Defra, 12:09.
Hello, Jackie Smith's voicemail. Please leave a message after the tone.
Oh, hello, Jackie. I'm Hilary returning your call. Just wanted to say thank you for inviting me along to your girls' night in. I'm very supportive of women in politics, and I'm sure that you'll get a lot of enjoyment from the face packs and the necklaces and things. But I suppose, not being a woman myself, I feel I should sort of maybe leave you to it. Anyway, thanks for the invite. Lots of love. Bye-bye.
Manhattan, 8:30, local time.
Oh, what a hangover. Oh, wait a minute. This isn't my hotel room.
Good morning.
Oh, no. Good morning.
So, quite the party at the United Nations last night, eh?
Yes. I think someone maybe spiked the punch. I can't remember anything.
No, nor me, nothing. Actually, I can remember everything.
Me too.
Look, I know this makes me sound like a bit of a slapper, but I have forgotten your...
Ehud Olmert.
Right. The Prime Minister of Israel.
Yes. And you?
Mahmoud Ahmadinejad.
Of Iran. I see. Look, I'd better be going.
You don't want to stay for coffee?
No. I've got, you know, some stuff to do.
Yes, me too.
Oh, and I'd really appreciate if we kept this, you know, to ourselves.
You read my mind.
Okay, then. So, see you around.
Yeah. Didn't even leave his mobile number.
Hello, you're through to Paul McCartney's voicemail. Please leave a message after the...
Hello, Paul. It's Ringo. I'd really like to know when the band's rehearsing again, because, like, it's been 35 bloody years, and I'm beginning to forget the songs. You know, if you don't want me in the band, then just say so, because I know Phil Collins, he's been sniffing around.
New York City, 9:53. Local time.
Sit yourself down in the makeup chair. We have some fabulous ideas.
I can't wait.
We've been thinking a lot about the whole Hillary Clinton look.
Well, that's what I pay you for.
Everybody's talking about change, and we think it's time you change your look. Just a small
change.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.